Mm-hmm. We'll put it back in the microwave for another 30 seconds.
We're not taking chances with
salmonella. We're not taking chances with salmonella. Back in 30 seconds. And there's our pastry cream.
Well, that looks beautiful.
And it's very thick. Mm-hmm. And then as it cools, it gets even thicker, but it almost reminds me of lemon curd.
Lovely smooth, too, isn't it?
Very hot.
Good. Mm-hmm.
And now we're going to fill some pastries.
Great.
All set to go?
Ready to go? Here's the dough.
The dough's all ready for rolling out. You can see the layers in there, can't you? Okay, now dust the dough with flour just to get everything nice and dry. And we're going to roll this out to do the shaping, and we're going to roll it out into a 10 by 20 rectangle. And I don't know what it is. I get so excited. I think I should do this really fast, but we don't need to do it that fast. And the dough actually performs better if you don't try to rush it. But if you roll it out slowly, it comes out very even. We're going to go a little bit further here because what we want to do is get 5-inch squares. So in order to have 5-inch squares, it's got to be 10 inches across. Okay, now you can be very precise.
Let's be very precise.
Okay, well, we'll
do it the right way.
There we go, 20 inches.
Yep.
Now we're going to cut it in half at the 5-inch mark. Then we'll just draw a straight line, just like a carpenter. Mm-hmm. The old carpenters say, you know, you should measure twice and cut once.
That's what my husband always used to say.
Is that right?
Yeah.
Now comes the fun part.
Yeah.
We're going to fill and shape pastries with our prune filling, with our apricot filling, and the pastry cream.
This will be nice. That's not just a bare tablespoon, is it?
If you're using a teaspoon, it's about around a teaspoon. Yeah. I like to be a little bit generous with the filling so that we have... So it's juicy. I like juicy rolls.
Yeah.
Next thing I'll do is paint the edges.
That's just beaten egg white.
Just with beaten egg white. We'll go all the way around the edges here because it acts as a kind of a glue when we start shaping the pastries here. Now, the first one that I'm going to shape is the packet. You pick up the corners like that, and if you just fold the corners over, they flop open while they're baking. But I pick them up and just kind of pinch them together and make a little top hat there. See, and I give it a little twist like that.
Just to hold it together.
To hold it together, but you get that nice little
blob on top. That's that parchment paper here.
And that's parchment paper on the, I always use parchment paper. Let's take this one and make what the Danes call the trikaner, the three corner.
Oh, the three corner.
And we just seal the edges here with your finger. And that's how the three corner is made. I mean, that's not...
Very simple.
Very simple.
You can decorate it with a piece of dough if you want it, I guess.
Yeah, we have a few little scraps here. We can brush the top and be fancy. We should really glue it down with white. Now, one of the favorite things I do with prune filling is at Christmas time, I make prune tarts. And that's a Finnish specialty. It is Christmas without prune tarts. And the way that those go is like this. You cut the corner to the center.
Mm-hmm.
Then you lift up the center.
Every other center.
Every other one.
No.
And there we go. Got a nice little star.
Well, that's nice. That is nice.
There's one that we didn't do yet that's very simple, and that is make the spandauer. That's what they call it.
Mm-hmm.
Kind of looks just like that. It's just like wrapping a baby in a blanket without pulling one end up.
That's very nice.
There we are.
Mm-hmm.
All set. And then they sit for about 3 minutes. We let them rise. And before we put them into the oven, we're going to brush them with egg white. And we have some here that we did a little bit earlier. And we'll sprinkle it with pearl sugar.
Oh, I've never seen that.
That is a sugar that's used all over in Scandinavia. In Minnesota, we can find it in the supermarket. But other people may have to look in the Scandinavian specialty stores or into Scandinavian mail catalogs.
Uh-huh.
Okay, now these go into a 400 degree oven. It'll bake for about 10 minutes.
Good. Oh, they look lovely.
They're all done. We'll transfer them onto the tray here.
Well, that's a good one. You just slide them on.
We could actually very easily slide them off onto the rack now, too, so they don't...
And they'll really cool nicely.
They'll cool nicely, and we won't have any...
So do them warm or cold or what?
That's the best way.
Warm.
Warm.
Yeah.
Okay, well, now we're going to make our frosting. Oh. We add two or three teaspoons of milk to a half a cup of powdered sugar. And it can be kind of a thin glaze. We have to sift the powdered sugar because it has some little lumps in it.
Like they always do.
They always do. And then I'm putting it into a plastic bag. I'm going to close it up.
Oh, that's a zipper lock. That's a wonderful.
Yeah. And then cut a little bit of the corner off.
Yeah.
And then we'll just drizzle.
Oh, well, that's very clever. That's kind of a royal icing, isn't it?
A royal icing made with milk, so it's not going to be as stiff as a royal icing would be.
Well, that's nice, isn't it?
Nice little glaze over the top, and they're
all soaked.
We're eating. Okay, here we have three different kinds of berries. Beautiful raspberries, blackberries, and blueberries. We're going to crush down to make about 2 cups of crushed berries. Get them coarsely crushed because the rest of the mashing will happen as it cooks. So we're going to add a cupful of sugar to this.
Mm-hmm.
And we'll mix the sugar in.
The sugar draws out juices too, doesn't it?
It does. You don't need to add any extra water. Okay, now they're ready for the microwave. And they'll cook for 18 minutes. We'll stir them two or three times in the middle. But I've already programmed this for 18 minutes. Okay, here it is. It's all cooked and cooled, and we added a tablespoon of lemon juice to it.
That's thickened up too, hasn't it?
Yeah. One thing you have to be sure to do is to cook it without a cover on it in the microwave because you want that all the moisture, the liquid to evaporate.
It makes a lovely jam.
Fresh tasting.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, well, we'll route our dough now. Now we have the second half of our pastry, and then we made our packets out of the first half.
You have your cold.
And sometimes when the dough is really cold, it's hard to start rolling. So I either pound it with my fist, or I'll pound it with the rolling pin.
Does this again go 20 by?
No, this one goes 16 by 10.
16 by 10.
Very fine. Very fine. Now we're going to take our parchment paper and put it underneath. This makes it a lot easier to transfer the filled bread. Now, the next thing I'll do is cut strips along each edge, about 3/4 of an inch or an inch apart, about a third of the way into the dough. Now, the next thing we'll do is take our love jam. Jam.
Bottled jam never tastes like it.
Never tastes the same as it. And we'll just spread it right down the middle. Because we're filling this braid with this jam.
Well, it doesn't look at all like a braid. I'll be very interested to see your movements from now on.
How the braid happens.
Yep.
And then one thing I needed to do is brush the edges with.
That's your same beaten egg white.
Beaten egg white.
And that same nice pastry cream.
The pastry cream, we just spoon that right over the top. And that's just like having berries and cream inside a Danish or a flaky pastry. Mm. So it's almost like a pie.
Mm-hmm.
Now the next thing we're going to do is turn this into a braid. And we'll do it just the way you braid. You pull the left side over the top like that. There we go.
Oh, that's nice, isn't it?
Makes a nice little braid.
Mm-hmm.
Kind of looks like lacing up a moccasin, doesn't it?
Yeah.
Okay. Now we'll brush this with some egg white. And now we'll transfer this onto the baking sheet. So if you want to put the baking sheet here, just move this over. Sprinkle the top with some of our pearl sugar again. Mm-hmm. Now this has to rise for about 30 minutes. and then it goes in the oven.
Do you want to cover on it?
We'll put a cover on it. There we are. Here it is. All baked.
It's
ready to
well
cool.
Swelled up nicely, hasn't it?
And then we'll just slide it right off the cookie sheet.
You see that? Wonderful it, having that paper, isn't it?
The paper makes it so handy. Then we have a glaze put on top of the, just to decorate.
Is that the same glaze?
It's not. Have? It's almost the same, except instead of cream, we use coffee.
Oh.
With the powdered sugar.
That'll show up more, too, won't it?
Well, and you know, a coffee is such an appropriate flavor here.
Mm. Oh, no, that looks very nice.
It doesn't take a whole lot, just enough to give it a shininess. So there.
It's wonderful what you've taught us today, Beatrice. This wonderful bread and then all these cute little pastries. And they're so good to eat.
Well, thank you. I love them myself.
Well, it was just a dear of you to come all the way from Minnesota.
Any day. Any day.
Then we thank you very much.
Thanks for having me.
Complete recipes for all the breads, cakes, cookies, and pies in this series and more.